Victory is mine. Praise God, you've given me the name. Hey, victory is mine. Hey, healing is in that name, Jesus. We have a victory. You fought the battle and won the victory. We have your name. Ha-la-la-la-la. Your name has prevailed. Your name prevailed in heaven. Ha-ba-ba-ba. Your name has prevailed in the earth. Your name has prevailed underneath the earth. Lord of Ha-la-ba-ha-ya. Jesus, you are Lord tonight. Jesus, you are Lord. Ha-ba-ba-ba-ya-ba-ta-ba-ta-mo-ko-ra. Jesus, you are Lord. Hey! Jesus, you are Lord. Let's praise him tonight. Jesus, you are Lord. Let it in. La, 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 la. Keep not silent. Ha, la, 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 la. Jesus, you are Lord. We thank you. Your name has been exalted. You've given us your name. You've given us the right to use your name. All power is in hallowed. In heaven and earth is in your name. Lord, we thank you for the name. Hey, we reign because of the name. Satan is defeated because of that name. You've given us all rights to use that name. Whatever we ask in that name, you promise, Lord. Haya, yaba, kora, masa, taya. Lord, we're going to rejoice. Hallelujah. Lift your voices and praise it. Lift your voices and praise it. That name has already prevailed. Oh, all power is in the name. All power and authority is in the name of Lord. We thank you. Hey, hallelujah. Heba, Seba. Hallelujah. Lord, we can pull down. Strongholds are pulled down in the name. Oh, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty. Hey, they are mighty. They are mighty. They are mighty. They are mighty through God. Through the name. Through the name of rejoice in the name. Peace is in the name. Victory is in the name. Salvation is in no other name given unto us whereby we might be saved. You're rich to all that call upon you, Lord. Yes, call upon you in truth. It's all in your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have a victory tonight. Hallelujah. We're going to rejoice. Hey, because the name has been given to us. The name has been given to us. All power in heaven, all authority in heaven is behind the name. Angels are behind the name. The heavenly host is behind the name. God is behind the name. Hallelujah. We prevail. Hallelujah. We thank you tonight, Lord. We give you the praise. Jesus is Lord. Shabbasa. Jesus, you are Lord. Siba. Lord, you made us. We have a victory, Lord. We have a victory. You have given us the keys to the kingdom. Oh, hallelujah. He's under my feet. And I sit with him in heavenly places. I sit with him, I'm seated with him. Hey, 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 hey. Satan is under my feet. I'm reigning with him. We reign as kings and priests. Hey, hey, haba, haba, sayanana. Hey, hey, how many believe you have the victory tonight? Give you my son, Tim Messiah. All right, shabak it out, shout it out. I'll tell my son, Tom. If you believe you have the victory tonight, glory. Oh, my son, Tom. Let's rejoice. Let's cast out a mastery tale. Oh, my son of a hammer, who's going to rejoice in what Christ has done for them? Who's going to rejoice? How about my sick tale? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Satan is under our feet. We are seated with Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. They that are joined unto the Lord are one. Hey, hey, hey. Hallelujah, Lord, we are united with you. We are drawn from your strength. We are drawn from you, Lord. Ha, ba, 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 ha, ya. All that we need, Lord, we draw from you. Our sufficiency is of you tonight. Oh, God, we thank you. Hiya. We give you praise and glory. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let's go and praise him. Let's make the devil a liar. He must have torn us down. Hey, keep us from being excited about what Christ has done. Oh, let it radiate us. Let it radiate. Hallelujah. Lift them higher. Let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified. Let's magnify him. Let's magnify him. Let's magnify him. Oh, let's lift him up. Let's thank him for what he has done. Let's rejoice in his salvation. Oh, God. Oh, God, we curse him out some more. Oh, let's rejoice. Let's rejoice. Let's rejoice. Let everyone that seek the Lord, let them rejoice. Let them be glad. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let them say continually, oh, God, let the Lord be magnified. Lord, we thank you tonight. Hey, hey, hey!
Hallelujah.
Let's get them a seat. Oh, yeah, the victory is ours. The victory is ours. Joy, higher, unspeakable, and full of glory came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Lord, we thank you tonight. Hey, 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 that's the joy of the Lord. In his presence there is fullness of joy. At his right hand there are pleasures evermore. Lord, we thank you tonight that that we have the victory. Hey, hey. How many can say we have the victory?
We have the victory. Glory.
Yes, keep on saying it. We have the victory. 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 My victory is ours. Victory is ours. Victory. Hey, halalaba, halalaba, let the weak say. Oh, God, let them weak come us out. Oh, let us say it. Let us say it. Let us say it continually. Let us say it continually. Oh, offer the sacrifice of praise continually. That is the fruit of our lips giving thanks unto him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Come, let us exalt as I exalt his name together. Lord, we thank you tonight. Woo! How about many gonna thank you tonight? Shirabahaya.
Glory.
I'm gonna open your mouth and thank you. Mokoraba Satanya. How many gonna share back it to you? Shirabahara Bahola. Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, you are Lord. Oh, you are Lord. You are Lord. You are Lord. You are Lord. Over every circumstance, over every situation. Over here. You are Lord, you are Lord, you are Lord, you are Lord, you are Lord. You are the author, you are the finisher of our faith.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There you go, Sister Shelly. Go ahead and speak it out. Shut up. Hallelujah. Kila Rabo Shinamanda. Lede de Kila Rabahaya. Lede Kela Randalabaha. Let's go and say Kila Rabaharaba. Horabahaya Rabaha. Glory be Kila Rabahoraba. Sunday of the Sunday. Praise your name, Jesus. Hey, we thank you, Lord. Shibanda. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hey, yeah.
Yes, the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Thank you, Lord. Jesus, you are Lord.
Yes.
Hey, Lord of all. Lord of all. Oh, you Lord, you Lord, you Lord, you Lord, you Lord, you Lord.
Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Yes.
Sharaba, Horaba, Haraba, Haraba, Karaba, Sataraba, Sataraba. Jesus, we thank you.
Yes, thank you. Praise you.
Jesus,
Lord. Jesus, name. Jesus, name.
Sharaba, Karaba.
Glory, glory, glory.
Yes, Saramanata.
Amen.
Thank you.
Yes. Everyone blessed.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know we're a little thin tonight, but we are here.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So we're going to see for those who couldn't make it tonight.
Yes.
So, this is what happens when we start getting close to, consecration,
Yes.
The devil, you rear his head, and try to derail us and get us off track and everything. But we're not going to let that keep us from what we're going to do.
Yes.
We've got a couple of confessions here.
Yes.
The first one is on page 31.
Yes.
Prayer of thanksgiving and praise.
Yes.
Oh. Yeah, this prevailing prayer. Mm-hmm. Together. Are we ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Father, I thank you for making total provisions for all my needs, those in the past, those now, and those yet to come. Your gracious heart is disposed to show your favors.
is a demonstration of your great love, mercy, and care for me. As the Father loves and pities his children, so do you love and pity those who fear you. You are my Lord, the faithful God, the Father of mercies, and the God of all comfort, and it is the cause of your kind nature and manifold mercies that we are sustained but are not consumed. Great is your faithfulness. Thank you and bless you for all of your benefits. You forgive all my iniquities, you heal all my diseases, you redeem my life from destruction. You crown me with loving kindness and tender mercies. You satisfy my mouth with good things, so that my youth is renewed like the eagles. Father, all that you have done and provided us have come through our Lord Jesus Christ. This was your plan before the beginning of time. Christ is willing to lay down his life before the world began. It's the reason why we could be so gracious and show us these mercies and such great kindness, which we see revealed in your compound names of Jehovah. In those names, your benevolent and compassionate heart is disclosed. Through these names, you have a covenant through your spirit to be the Lord of there always with me, Jehovah Shalom. The Lord my peace, Jehovah Shalom. The Lord my provider, Jehovah Jireh. The Lord my banner, captain of war victory, Jehovah Nissi. The Lord my shepherd, Jehovah Ra. The Lord my righteousness, Jehovah Sitkis. The Lord my physician, Jehovah Ra.
Father, the things that you have done for me have not been due to what I merit or good works which I perform, but because of your graciousness and kind nature. You are full of compassion, ready to forgive and plenteous in mercy. Because you delight in mercy, you are ever looking from one end of the earth to another to show yourself strong on behalf of those whose hearts are trusting and relying on you. Your desire to bless me and meet all my needs is more than I want to see my needs met and set. Thank you for your unspeakable gift, Jesus Christ. Every good and every perfect gift comes from above and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom no variable, none shall return. You open his hand and loaded us with benefits daily, and satisfy the desire of every living thing. For you are Lord over all, and it is not rich unto all that call upon you. To all that call upon you in truth. You are just as willing to respond to my need, but full of eager yearning. You are eagerly awaiting the opportunity to release your blessings upon me. It is a time to see from you, and my prayers are answered, and my needs met, and my joy is full. Your desire for me is that my joy be full. Inasmuch as you did not spare your own son, but delivered him up for us all, is evident enough for me to know that you are not a tightness to God, who is in the business of withholding blessings from me. If you did not hold back your best, your son, you will not refuse to give me a hold back the rest. Because Jesus was offered up for us all, and have become our merciful and faithful high priest, the reservoir of blessings and rewards, and the fountain of blessings that become full to overflowing, causing your grace to be poured out and released into my life in great profusion. Father, I thank you and bless you for your manifold mercies, and for your abundant grace.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
response to that?
That's good. Got nothing to say about it, no response. Come on, y'all, say something.
They have something to say about the next one.
The next one.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got something to say about this one.
Go ahead.
He said, you forgiveth all of our iniquities. You healeth all of my diseases. We got to take that on. I take it on, yes, Lord, you heal me.
Right.
Yeah, and then you redeem my life from destruction, all this right in here.
It's all good.
It's all good.
It's good to be able to verbalize it and just say, Lord, this is good what you've done. Hallelujah.
What's the next one?
Yeah, it's on page 34.
34.
Prayer, consecration, and dedication. Because we're ready to enter into that.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Amen. Are we ready?
Yes.
Father, I consecrate and rededicate my life to you.
May you always be the object of my desire, prayer, faith, and hope. I repent of my lukewarmness and my lack of heart, sincere and pure devotion to Christ and to you. I present my body to you as a living sacrifice. That I commit to be more consecrated and devoted to you for your purpose, for your glory. I make the decisions and commitment to wholly follow your will for my life, and to make the things you are primarily interested in the chief interest of my life. Lord, help me to place all my personal ambitions secondary to your will for my life. Help me to become willing to pay the price of denying my flesh of the things that I do, which are contrary to your word and to your will for my life. Father, I know the grateful jealousy you must feel with something that the poor son of else captures my heart and lead me away from a pure and sincere devotion to you. You must feel like I would give you, but I suddenly realize that someone has captured the heart and thought of someone I truly love that is most close to me. Help me to return to my first love and to a wholehearted sincere devotion to you. Let that overwhelming sense of me that drew me to you when I first received you be restored.
Yes.
Help me to be ever aware of my need of you in every area of my life at all times. Just as I'm aware of my physical needs, may I always be keenly aware of my spiritual, mental, and emotional needs and the needs of others. The more that I am aware of my needs, the more intense will be my prayer. The more I'm aware of the needs of others, the more intense will be my intercession. The more I am aware that it is God that is meeting my need, the more genuine will be my thanksgiving. Lord, help me be consistent. Be aware of every good and perfect gift comes from above. All that I have ever needed, your hands have provided. When I have eaten and are full and enjoying the works of my hands and many of the comforts of life, help me to always remember that it is you that gives me the power of the ability to get what I have. Let not my heart be lifted up in pride and think these things that I receive are due to my own doings, strength, and wisdom. I will always remember and bless you for all your benefits. When I am well filled for the present and secure for the future, constantly remind me of the temptation to become lax, lukewarm, and half-hearted. Never let me stray and become so distracted and lose my fear of you, and become bold in doing things that displease you. Never permit me to become so prideful to think that I can avoid the consequences of violating your word. Now, Father, I'm making a decision of my body, which all belongs to members and faculties. I make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its desires. I choose as an act of my will to bring my flesh and all of its affections and lust in subjection to the will of God. I deprive of power the evil desires lurking in my members and those evil impulses and tendencies that will cause me to exalt myself and draw me into sin. I put to death all sexual vices, impurity, sensual appetite, unholy desire, and attitude, all pride, greed, covetousness, and all that offend you. As I have yielded my members in the past as servants of unbelief and to iniquity, even so now I yield my members as servants to righteousness and holiness.
Jesus'
name.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise
the Lord.
All right.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Is that right on time?
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. This is something that we could probably read maybe on Wednesday night and probably Sunday. When quite a few of the members are there. So get them to start buying into and thinking about getting control of our flesh and everything that we need to do in preparation for this consecration.
Yeah,
right.
That's good.
And even doing the consecration. I'd like to spend some hours, you know. I feel so energized until I feel like I'm physically back up to, you know, spending, you know, hours doing the prayer week, consecration next week.
Yes.
We can meet, we can decide whether we want to come an hour or two before, but I think that we really need to try to get as much of these things in us and try to help people to start reading these things and the other things from the other book. And just spend time and just feeding yourself on the word. Just feeding yourself on the word and praising God. Those two things, just taking it in, feeding on it, and praising God for whatever the word is saying about us. Amen. I think that that would be the biggest breakthrough that we could ever hope for. And I think that we'll be energized to really begin to move forward and really begin to do the work of the ministry. So I'm open. I know Monday evening we come. I know everybody's schedule is different, but Sister Shirley, you're available on the day?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're going to set some hours that we can come and just feed on the word and try to get more into us. Because I believe the entrance of the word is the thing that gives us life.
Amen.
And give us light to and life. And we just need more because, you know, we got to have a lot more because those that's not doing anything hurt, they're draining us. And we're trying to move forward, and sometimes we feel the load, and people don't understand what we're talking about, what we're preaching about, what we're praying about. So we got to do everything that we can to bring victory even among our own people.
Yeah.
So it's going to take some hours. So anybody got some time? I know on Wednesday we had said that we used to meet at 10. I know we could, 5 o'clock is a good time for me in the morning, or 10 o'clock during the morning. But we just want to pick up whoever we can pick up. And we can just,
you know. Still good for me. 10 still good for me, always.
And then in the evening, you know, that, you know, we can come in for a couple of hours and from 5 to 7 or 6 to 8 or, you know, whatever hours would be best for everybody. I guess we can come to an agreement on that Sunday when we meet. But we just need to make an all-out effort, because if we could take all of this consecration into the fourth Saturday, I think it could be a lot more beneficial to 4 hours culminated with a 4-hour prayer. Amen. You can have a lot of fun, amen, just feeding on your favorite stuff. Amen. Talk to yourself. And, you know, a couple of hours praying in the spirit, singing if you want it.
Yes.
Amen. And dance on it if you want to. Amen. Praise God. So, anybody else got anything? How many believe that we need all that we can get?
Amen.
Glory. Praise God. Anything stands out in all of this that Brother Travis read? Anything that registered with you?
Yes.
I will share a testimony. I think 2 weeks ago we did have a layoff on our job. And thank the Lord that they decided to keep an old hand like me around. But it's just truly to show God to you know, his faithfulness through his word and how he just keep, you know, encourage me that through the hour of God of what's going on, that he always gonna, you know, see the things work out regardless. Mm-hmm. And to continue just to put my trust in him. Yes. And even though they wind up kind of moving me from where I was, you know, the devil always try to do things to make you seem like it's a bad thing, you know. Mm-hmm. And you just had to, through the courage through my wife, and because yes. Sometimes in my mind, just feel like I say, you know, forget it. I quit. Give me a package. I go. Because when you get, you know, been around places as long as I have, you know, and I think the one guy that that let go has been there about 31 years. And probably one of the helpful, most helpful ones that was for the shop personnel that was there. And probably 58, 59 year old, you know, so. And just see the, you know, company or the, some of the managers not have no regards. Mm-hmm. And that's why I'm just saying, I continue to put my confidence and faith in God.
Yes, yes.
And right. Through even this experience, this move was required, you know, I had to do some retraining and you know, sometimes my mind don't want to absorb the new concept, you know. And if you get so used to what you're doing and complacent in what you're doing, this one machine, you just, you know, it's comfortable doing it, but now you have to start over again or train in something different. Mm-hmm. And could I, you know, sometimes I think about what David had said, complained about, you know, Lord, like why I had to go through this, you know, at this time and stage in my life, I feel like, you know, I think this year it'd be 29 years of me. So, and I guess, you know, most companies these days, they don't, you know, they really don't want people to be around that long. Mm-hmm. It's true for the matter. Mm-hmm. And of course, you know, they, some of the help they bring in there, the younger guys or whatever. But I just know it's just in all things, God will cause everything to work out for the good.
Amen.
No matter what that you're facing, even this thing that I'm going through, one of the guys they put me with to do the training, you know, I thank God that I'd be able to, you know, share my testimony with him, to tell him, you know, and show him what, you know, how God has been good to me. Mm-hmm. You know, and just tell him about what the thing that God has done in my life, and likewise he began to share things about his life. And you know, people, there are things in people's life that have happened to them. Mm-hmm. and experiences that they went through. And sometimes you feel like, you know, what you've been through, it seems like it's been very hard and devastating. Mm-hmm. But then when you start talking to them and finding out, well, man, you've been through a whole lot yourself. And he, you know, and he always wears hair long, and he starts showing me how a lot of the managers picked on him because of his hair was long, and that's part of his culture. And they always wanted to tell him put his hair inside his shirt, and kind of really ridiculed him for that. And a lot of time, myself, I always thought that they tried to pick on because even through this move right here, it really was for movement, but also God is good. Amen. You know, I thank God that through all that, you know, when you get an opportunity to be by myself, I think about the scripture. I think of Psalm 117, you should not be moved by evil tidings. Mm-hmm. And he would keep our hearts in peace whose mind is stayed upon him. Yes. And I thank God that I can meditate on that scripture, that what I've been taught here that through it all. And his faithfulness, and like what her shared by the scripture, by remembrance of what he had done in the past, and how he showed himself faithful even then, and even now, he's showing himself faithful and coming in, you know, and allowing me to hang around there, you know. And, you know, it's all that, what I have done, you know, it's been worth it. Amen. Being faithful here, coming in prayer. And being amongst the people and the saints, you know, my giving, but God is good. And, you know, I don't have no sad story. All I can just say, encourage you to continue to pray for the saints, because well, I believe that what you hear, what's going on in the economy and all of that, and it affects the, you know, not only the people, when it affects the people, it affects the church as a whole. Yeah. The mood of the people, the mood of the church, and we don't have, like I say, something to stand on when things come up against you. Then, like I have felt, was it, throw my hands, forget it, I move on, take my little two-bottle, roll on out of there, you know? that's why I told my wife this several times, hey, I had enough of this, because I know in fact, it's a fact that days are numbered anyway, you know what I mean? But I know regardless, God brought me there for a time in the season, for the time that he had me there. But I know even beyond that, you know, he will always supply our need. He always will come through for us regardless of what we might be facing. And he has shown himself faithful every single time. When it seemed like I'm back against the wall, he come into my rescue. It might not maybe change, seem like it's uncomfortable for me to go through what I'm going through, but yet through it all, I begin to just tell God, thank you. Thank you for what you're doing for me. Thank you for meeting my needs according to your original and glory across Jesus. Because that mark that was in the middle of the aisle where I came when he showed up for me when I first came there 27 years ago, that I can walk through there, and when I walk past there, I said, thank you, Lord, for providing. And even today, you know, I do that, and I walk through there and tell him thank you. And he needed to be young there, because there are so many things and ideas that I really like to try. That's why I told my wife, go ahead, I'm retired. Because there's some things that I would like to try out. And I believe that, because see, I have learned that, you know, just because you give, God don't just provide just because you give. That just starts the foundation of God working on your hand. But you got to have something in your hand for God to work with. If you have some kind of business, some kind of idea, something for him to work with. Because he asked Moses, what do you got in your hand? Well, Moses, I got this old staff. It seemed like something of nothing of value. And that what we have on the inside, is sometimes it seems like it's nothing of value. But that's what God sees is something of value for him to use to bless us and to do carry out what his will and purpose for our life. And we put our trust and confidence in him. Because it is he that supplies. We still sometimes, if we step out and believe and trust him, well, I believe he'll undergird us and bring us through and bring us to more than what we were when we were with that from the beginning. Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen. Yeah, praise the Lord. Wayne, as you were talking, you know what came to my mind to share with you is remember Joseph. Mm-hmm. Remember the situation he was in and how he was brought out. Yes. Mm-hmm. Just remember him.
Yes.
Remember Amen. Joseph.
Yes. The plan that God had for his life was thwarted. They tried to thwart it out.
Yeah, but they couldn't.
Kept coming back.
Yeah.
Like that beach ball trying to push it down under the water.
Yeah.
It keeps you back up.
And all of the things that happened to him was in, you know, making him so he could, when he got to that level, what's on the inside of you. You've gone through all of this and that, and you got to that level, that's been perfected.
Yes.
And you can handle it. I mean, what God is going to birth within you, all those experiences you've had, they haven't been for naught. They have not been for naught. There's a reason for it.
Amen.
Yeah.
I think one of the greatest things we can also praise God for is that God is working on our behalf, just like all of the redemptive work was on our behalf. And that accomplished, God knows, nobody can explain the depths of what Christ did over 2,000 years ago, but just think about what Christ is doing now. He's committed to making sure that every promise, he's the surety of our covenant. He wants to make sure that every promise, every provision, and when we enter into a blood covenant with Christ, that is a sure way of Christ getting involved with everything that pertains to us.
Yes.
He backs us 100%. He wants to make sure that every blessing, every benefit, and everything that we have believed for will always come to pass.
And
he's interceded. He's mediated. I mean, the work of Christ is phenomenal now at the right hand of the... If we could understand what he's doing for us now.
And you mentioned David. And what did David say? He said, I've been young and I'm old, yet have I never seen the righteous forsaken. The righteous forsaken, seed.
He has to do that. God has to
nor
do that.
Now his seed bear bread.
Once we come into a covenant relationship.
I don't care what they do, how many times they transfer you, put you on the new machine and all. He said, never seen the righteous forsaken. Never.
God is under obligation to abandon all
of his seed begging bread. Never.
Amen.
Believe it. Praise God. It's a wonderful testimony.
Well, they have something to say too, I guess. God hasn't reversed your blessings, has he?
No, he hasn't reversed them, but, you know, I thank God every day, and I get up and, you know, I pray and I read and I meditate.
And these apartments that we got to walk up 5 stories, 5 flights. Mm-hmm. They took the elevators out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, you know, that's quite naturally, that's hard on them. On a person her age, it's hard on me, you know. But so she said to them, she said, well, if you're going to do that, she said, you're going to let me work part-time. He said, yeah, I'll let you work part-time and I'll pay your insurance, you know, and everything like that. She said, well, you know, she said, I stuck my neck out for Al. He said, oh, we don't have no problem with Al. Mm-hmm. We're just happy with him.
Wow.
And we don't want to see him go anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And the owner came to me and he told me, he said, you know, once construction is out of here, he said, you know, we just want you to do what you do because we appreciate what you do.
Mm-hmm.
And so it put a tear in my eye. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, I thought back, you know, God has seen my work.
Mm-hmm.
He knows what I do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I try to make it to church every chance I get. I try to make it to prayer.
Mm-hmm.
I come to Bible study.
Mm-hmm.
And he rewards us.
Oh, yes,
you know? So I'm just thankful and I'm grateful for what he's done.
Absolutely.
And so the Kathy, she was crying. And, you know, like I said, she's a friend of mine. So I went to her, she was crying. And I didn't want to just kind of go over the hill or anything like that, but I waited till the next morning. And I went to her, and me and her was talking, and she had big tears in her eyes. But I said, do you pray? And she said, well, yeah, but you know, she said, you know, prayers for those that are really seeking something.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how she put it.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, Kathy, I said, I pray all the time.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, you know, God is just telling me right now that if we lay hands, and touch and agree,
mm-hmm.
he's gonna do something for you.
Mm-hmm.
So we prayed, this was last Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
Well, today, they told her that they're gonna increase her hours.
Oh,
She came to me and she had, you know, I mean, she was just as happy as she can be, you know. She had all that mascara and it was just running all down her face. But, you know.
23.
Yeah. But she said to me, she said, you know, Al, she said, I get on Facebook, and she said, every time I get on Facebook and I see the things that you put on Facebook, I never put anything on Facebook without recognizing who God is. Mm-hmm. I don't put anything else on that. I see some people, they put things on Facebook that, you know, they could praise God one minute, and the next minute, you know, they showing the drinks or the women or the men. You know, I want to be right with God. Mm-hmm. And so I just, you know, like, it's not, it's just God in me. Mm-hmm. And I see what God is doing, and you know, he's opening up doors for me. He's opening up doors for my family. And they gave him a job as a forklift driver. Wow. And so, you know, I'm just grateful for what God is doing. And I see what God is doing. And my wife and I, we started our fast and consecration pastor last week.
All right.
Now, we cheated and ate a little meat over the weekend. But we got back on it today. But you know, I'm just holding fast what I know God can do. Amen. And so I'm going to let God just do what he does, because he do it better than what we do.
Amen.
So
Amen.
We just got to keep on praying and trusting God, and he'll do things for us.
Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Good
reports. All right. Yes, it is. That's good. All right.
Yes. Amen.
Those were Flower Sunday morning.
Yes.
Yes. Amen. Glory.
God is faithful.
Shout out.
Yes,
oh,
yes, yes, yes. Praise God.
Yes. Sister Sheridan, I'm asking you to close us out with a prayer.
Oh, okay.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you. We praise you, Father God. We magnify you.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you for your dear son.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you for the people that gathered here tonight in your name, Father.
Yes.
We pray for the ones that couldn't come, Lord. Put your protective shield around them, Lord, and lead them. Let them know, Father, that they should come to prayer.
Thank you, Father.
Lord, we just, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for your word. Lord, I thank you for our members here at the church. Lord, we want you to put your protective shield around our children, Lord, and be their protector. Father God, the one that's gone astray, Lord, I know you can bring them back, and that's what you said in your word, you'll bring them back. Father, we ask you to bring them back to you and give us, on while we're on our way home, Lord, put your protective shield around us that we get home safe and sound, no harm or hurt come to us.
Yes.
Father, I'm saying this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen